One of the most alarming things about the development and use of new untested chemicals is how long the harmful ones can be with us, because it may be as long as forever. Persistent organic pollutants, known as POPs, is a group of chemicals that have common features, including persistence in the environment, meaning they don't break down for decades or even hundreds of years. Bioaccumulation, they accumulate in the fatty tissue of animals, including us. And long-range transport, meaning that they can be found in every part of the world, even the Arctic. These attributes, combined with their toxicity, means they can have an adverse effect both on wildlife and on the human population. POPs were widely used after World War II, when thousands of synthetic chemicals were introduced for industrial use, and many proved beneficial in the short term, but they had unforeseen effects on human health and the environment. For example, decades ago, we first learned about the pesticide DDT and that it is harmful because of its impact on the eggshells of bald eagles. Behavioral abnormalities and birth defects in fish, birds, and mammals in and around the Great Lakes actually led scientists to investigate POP exposure in the human population. People are exposed to POPs through contaminated food, water, and even air pollution. Adverse health effects on reproductive, developmental, behavioral, neurologic, endocrine, and immune systems have all been linked to POPs. Sensitive populations, including children and the elderly, and those with suppressed immune systems, are typically even more susceptible. POPs include intentionally produced chemicals like pesticides and PCBs, as well as chemicals that result from industrial processes, including dioxin. Dioxin is a common environmental pollutant that is highly toxic and can cause reproductive and developmental problems. It can also damage the immune system and interfere with hormones and even cause cancer. Dioxins are found throughout the world in the environment, and they accumulate in the food chain, mainly in the fatty tissue of animals. They're also contained in drinking water and some consumer products, including small amounts in cigarettes. Though the levels of dioxin reaching the environment have decreased in the last 30 years, dioxins are extremely persistent compounds and they break down very slowly. In fact, a large part of the current exposures to dioxins is due to releases that occurred decades ago. In a study at the University of Rochester, researchers exposed pregnant mice to dioxin. Then they assessed the immune response of their offspring. An impaired response was observed not only in the first generation of offspring, but also in subsequent generations. That's called transgenerational toxicity, and the implications are alarming. Forever chemicals released into the environment many years ago may also be persistent in their harmful effects on wildlife and on humans for generations. The issue of persistent organic pollutants shows us that the problem with chemicals is not just limited to their direct impact on us today. They impact the environment around us as well, as long as forever. The problem of persistent organic compounds makes our mission even more important, to reduce our exposure to these harmful chemicals before they get into the environment. The things we want to last forever have nothing to do with chemicals. Let's look out for future generations today by eliminating persistent organic pollutants from our homes and our world.